For each lesson, Hawk's unique mastery approach provides three distinct modes: learn, practice, and certify. With a focus on a simplistic, consistent interface, students can easily follow the natural progression of the recommended learning path. Learn is a multimedia presentation of the textbook content and includes rules, definitions, properties, and interactive examples. Designed to engage students in their own learning process, Learn includes opportunities to interact with the content at the time they're introduced to the concepts. Hawks provides brief video clips of instructors working through problems that relate to the content found within the lesson. In addition to the videos embedded within each lesson, we have a website called Hawks TV, which offers a full library of videos for students to access as an open education resource. The next step of the recommended learning path is practice. This is a penalty-free environment where students solve algorithmically generated questions. In this mode, students have access to learning aids for each question until they become confident in the material. The practice mode functions just like a textbook in that students have the flexibility to skip over questions they have already mastered and focus on content they need to work on by selecting the skip button. Beside the skip button, the try similar button provides students with an unlimited number of practice problems without repeating questions they've already answered. The last button on the row is the tutor button. I'll come back to this, but I first want to show you how a student answers a question. So let's go ahead and input an answer here. Students will use the keypad or keyboard shortcuts for any symbol or functions. What I've done is entered a pretty common mathematical mistake. The reason I'm showing you this is that I want to highlight one of the most unique and beneficial tools in our courseware. When a student makes a mistake, they have two options. They can either try the question again, or they can select Explain Error. As with any program, students are told whether they're correct or incorrect. At Hawks, we take it a step further. Our artificial intelligence anticipates and diagnoses common mathematical errors. Instead of just telling your student it's wrong, it tells him or her why they got the question wrong, which is the key to the learning process. This feedback is critical because it guides students as they are learning the content and making mistakes in real time, as opposed to professors sharing the feedback in class a few days later. By addressing the error immediately, once it is made, we can prevent those mistakes from moving into students' long-term memory. Now, we will go back to the tutor feature. When students come to a problem and don't know where to begin, they can utilize the tutor button instead of just putting in a random guess. The tutor takes the problem at hand and breaks it up into more workable, approachable steps, walking the student through the problem in pieces, essentially being a guide to help solve the problem. Anything hyperlinked in blue can be clicked on, giving the student an immediate refresher on that particular concept. Students can use as much or as little guided assistance as they feel they need in order to successfully learn how to solve the problem. Also, you can see the tab that says View Solutions. This shows students how we would recommend writing out the problem. As you know with mathematics, it's really when pencil goes to paper that learning retention takes place, and it's important for students to see how to structure writing out steps. The final mode of our courseware is what we call Certify. This is the homework that you will assign to your students and that they'll complete for credit. Just like practice, the questions are algorithmically generated. In Certify, students get a unique homework assignment so that each student is responsible for completing their own problems. The biggest difference in these two modes is the elimination of the learning aids. Students no longer have the tutor or skip button. They are now held accountable for truly learning the material and demonstrating a competency of the collective set of concepts. This is something that we feel is very important. No more hand-holding when it comes to homework. Each assignment here is mastery-based. We give your students a set number of questions. Of those questions, students are allowed to miss a few and still get credit for homework. However, students must get about 80% of the questions correct in order to pass. By pass, we mean achieving 100% or full credit for completing the assignment. For example, take a look at the mastery meter in the top right-hand corner. In this case, students receive a set number of questions. Of those questions, they're allowed to miss a set number of strikes or allowed to miss a specific number of questions and still pass. If a student misses more than the allowed number of strikes, that student is actually taken from Certify and placed back into practice, where they will receive a tailored learning path with a customized set of questions combined with the high level of error-specific feedback you saw earlier for an adaptive learning experience. This allows students to focus on the areas where they need additional practice before attempting Certify again. With mastery-based learning, students receive an unlimited number of attempts to demonstrate mastery of the lesson. Once a student feels confident, they can go back to Certify and attempt a new problem set again. This is motivational for students because they know they can attempt the assignment as many times as they need before the due date without penalty. Now, we realize that this type of mastery approach isn't typical of what students are used to or typical of what other systems present as mastery. However, it is the type of mastery that really encourages and drives student comprehension of topics, which is exactly what you would hope for when you have students completing homework assignments. Furthermore, mastery-based learning is inherently adaptive in that it enables students to move at their own pace of learning the material. One of the analogies I like to use to describe this type of mastery is to think of it as if you were learning to play a piece of music. Most systems present students with a set of math problems to complete. The student will typically begin working on the first problem in the set. They'll get that problem either correct or incorrect. If they answer it incorrectly, then they'll be presented with another version of that exact same type of problem, and again will either get it right or wrong. But as soon as the answer is correct, they'll move on to the next problem type in the set. They will then continue working through the set, answering each problem type correctly one time only. This would be like attempting to play your piece of music, perhaps it's a piano, by banging around on the keys to play the first note, hitting a bunch of wrong notes, finally finding the correct one, and moving on to the next note. You'll then repeat the process by banging around on the keyboard to find the second note, finally finding the right one and then moving on to the next. If you work through the entire piece of music this way, when you reach the end of the song, sure, you played each note correctly one time, but you've had so many wrong notes interspersed between that no one would really be able to recognize the song, and you couldn't really say that you've learned or mastered it. Now, the difference is that our system has been designed to create an overall mastery goal where students are required to master entire concepts, not just memorize individual pieces of individual problems. This mastery works much differently and is more typical of how you usually teach yourself something. You attempt an entire song from beginning to end. You allow yourself a few mistakes along the way, the strikes, but you practice the entire problem set or song in its entirety from beginning to end, over and over until you've finally mastered it, or you've really learned the song. When you think about our courseware in this way, you can see then how students would have a much stronger understanding of the material when working with Hawks, and this really is how we're able to eliminate the disconnect we see with other systems when students turn their homework in for 100% but can't perform at that same level on tests or quizzes covering the same topics. Our courseware is adaptive in its presentation of content required for mastery by each learner based on their pace, skill, and knowledge level. Math is not a spectator sport, so the expectation is that the student will learn by doing, which is exactly what they'll do with our system.